Will you be able to hit max rank in Halo 5 before the release of Halo Infinite? Stay tuned throughout this video to see if you'll be able to. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving our commentary here. Today we're going to be breaking down some math right now when it comes to the XP gain in Halo 5. So if you guys like these news, informational kind of tips and tricks kind of videos, please make sure to tap that like button as it lets me know you want to see some more content like this. Leave a comment down below what your current rank is in Halo 5 and if it's going to be possible for you after watching this video. Do you think if you'll be able to hit max rank? And if, also, if you're new to the channel, want to update with anything Halo related, please make sure to tap that subscribe button with the bell, because we all know sub boxes can be kind of weird at times. So let's get right into the video here. Remember a previous video I uploaded talking about, well, two videos I uploaded talking about this, where if you hit max rank 152, you will be rewarded with something in Halo Infinite. So that really motivated a lot of people to start grinding it out to get there. But the thing is, the way the XP levels go towards the end, it's rather ridiculous, because it's, you know, rather linear rip until like 140. When it comes to XP needed to rank up to the next level. But when you go from 140 to 152, it's rather exponential. As you can see, this bar graph right here kind of showing you the general rank up of XP needed. As you can see, it seems like there's a little bit of a dip about every 10 levels or so, then it kind of goes back up, but it's rather linear, a little bit of an exponential curve to it, but rather, you know, straightforward. But once you hit 140, I'll show you right here that it's just like ridiculous. This is the graph resized right here for scale, where you see 140 and then it goes like, okay, that's fine, and then like right when you hit about 147 is when it gets ridiculous. As you can see, it just goes swoops straight up to be a straight up exponential grind for XP. I listed out here in a spreadsheet showing the amount of XP needed for each level. So in this video, what I wanted to go through is kind of give you guys some examples of general kind of levels you will have to expect, and also what kind of XP you will be expecting to earn while playing Halo 5 to hopefully get a chance to, you know, get that 152 special, whatever it will be, in Halo Infinite. So I put together a spreadsheet. I worked out some of the XP gains and give you some guys predictions of how long it will take to rank up and, you know, hopefully get this. So let's get right into the spreadsheet here. Okay, guys, don't freak out. It's numbers, I know, but this is very important stuff to figure out if you're going to be able to, if it's worth spending your time getting those gains when it comes to getting XP. So I put together a spreadsheet of kind of basically some simple equations of how the rank up will work in Halo Infinite. So we can go look at the top right here. For example, this will be, well, say if you're level 125, you're like, I think I can do it. We can go over to this one tab I put together. This is a list of all the XP needed for each level. So you're 125, which means that your XP level, which should be right here at 4,938,000 XP is what you'll be needing. I input it right here. So you'll need a grand total of 45,065,000 XP to get to the max rank of 50 million XP of 152. So I put together here a list right here saying, hypothetically, if the game releases this year, which I highly doubt that, for Halo Infinite. So I did 365 days, subtracted the month of December, because it's not going to come out in December. If it was going to come out this year, it'd be either October or November. So let's just say a November release date. So I subtracted 31 days out of the year here. So it gives you how much XP you need to earn per day for a 2019 release. But you can see it's 134,925 with some decimals after that. That's how much XP you'll need per day to get to 152. And also, but more likely this game of Halo Infinite will release in 2020, which would mean that, you know, we have a much longer time to earn out this XP here. And so then again, subtracting the month of December, but adding up basically 2 years minus 31, and that would equate to you having to earn 64,470 XP per day. That's every day until November of 2020. So that's one hell of a grind right there. So let's say, well, how many games would I need to play of each mode, hypothetically? Now, that does kind of take into consideration what mode you do play and how well you do in the mode, and also if it's like a double XP playlist or something like that, or maybe some random weekend they'll give quadruple XP. I don't know, but like, so there are some variables right here, but I'll give you a nice solid baseline to where you can get a good judgment off of this. So when you want to play the Warzone playlist, Probably the most consistent mode you can play to get XP would be Legendary Warzone Firefight. If you're, you know, top 3 on the lobby, you get enough kills and things like that, you can get roughly about 6,500 XP, roughly, depending on your performance as well. Where if on the arena side of things, it's rather balanced out, really, so you can pretty much play whatever. You'll be gaining about 3,175 XP per game. I worked that out because I added up the last 10 matches I played of Team Arena. I didn't use any boosts, and so I also took out the outliers, to say games that were incomplete or games where people quit out, but it gave me roughly 3,178 XP per game. And so I rounded it down to 75 just to kind of, you know, make it easier on the numbers right there. So, Legendary Warzone Firefight. If we're gonna play, planning on a 2019 release, this means you would have to play at least 20. We'll round up on this one as well, a little bit. So you have to play at least 21 games of Warzone Firefight per day before our 2019 release. Now, and then if for a week, that means you have to play 145 matches. For a month, you have to play 581 matches per month of Warzone Firefight if it was a 2019 release. If we're talking a 2020 release, you have to play 10 matches of Warzone Firefight per day, or that also equates to about 70 to 69 matches per week, and also roughly 278 matches per month. For Team Arena stats right here for a 2019 release, you would have to play an outstanding amount of 43 games per day. You'd be damn good at the game too, by the way, if that ever came around. But that's, and then also if it was per week, that equates to 297 matches for a 2019 release, and for per month, that equates to 1,190 matches per month. So that's a lot. But if we do a 2020 release, which is much more likely to happen, we'll see that you have to play at least 20 matches per day, at least 142 per week, and at least 569 matches per month. So one hell of a grind right there. Now, this is not taking into consideration XP boosts that you get as well. Those greatly help out your numbers. So normally when I'm playing Legendary Warzone Firefight, I have a lot of rare XP boosts on while playing Legendary Warzone Firefight. I was able to roughly average out 18,855 XP per match. So let's put this into our equation right here. And you can see that greatly helps out our numbers quite a bit. Where if you're going for a 20, I'll just go forward with the 2020 release. I don't bore you guys too many numbers, but that equates to 3.5 matches per day, about 24 a week, and about 95 Legendary Warzone matches played per month. But using these XP boosts are huge. So say if you're a much higher level, let's say like for me, I'm at 148 right now. So if we go check out our spreadsheet right here, 148 means I need to have 14 million XP. So let's check it out, let's put it into our spreadsheet here. It's 148 level. Current XP level amount of experience needed means I have 36 million XP still to earn. Now, the thing you gotta take into consideration, that to get to level 151, you need a grand total of 35 million XP earned. So for me to go from 148 to 152 is more than it takes to go from 0 to 151. So one hell of a grind for me to get any chance of this to happen. So for me, this means I'd have to play roughly about 2.5 matches still of Warzone Firefight, Legendary Warzone Firefight, with a rare boost on. I have like 135 saved up, so that makes things a lot easier for me. Now for the Team Arena side of things, it takes me 16 games per day still to get for Team Arena XP level. So that's a lot of gaming right there. I'm just would not be able to do that. Now that's why these Legendary Warzone packs are so, or Legendary XP boost packs are so important to use and pick up whenever you get a chance for that to happen. This recently did just happen on for Halo 5, where you're able to get a Legendary XP boost for Arena and Legendary XP boost for Warzone. If I remember correctly, each pack costs about 150,000 rec points, and so that's one thing you have to take into consideration. So you probably, if you kind of hop back and forth between Warzone and also Team Arena, you want to have at least 300,000 rec points saved up, so you can get a chance to really boost your numbers up a lot. And if you tag those legendary boosts along with a double XP weekend or double XP playlist, which, you know, does happen quite often, then you really get grinded on those points. I know, like, Mint Blitz is really grinding out the XP right now, and he's able to get like a million in a single day using the different, you know, XP boosts and playing certain playlists and also playing a lot. And just for another example here, say you're level 137 right here, your current XP points are at 5,980. You would need to earn 44,020,000 XP to get to 152. So that equates to, for a 2020 release, that means for like Legendary Warzone Firefight, if you're using rare boosts, that means you'll be having to play at least 3 matches a day of Legendary Warzone Firefight, equating to about 95 a month as well. Also taking consideration that Unishek did say on Twitter that maybe this reward for hitting max rank might not be the most ultra rare awesome thing to get in the game. So this is supposed to kind of give you guys a little bit of perspective of how much time you're going to need to put in to get a chance to hopefully get that max rank. It seems like it's still possible for me at 148 if I play my cards right, you know, using the proper boost at the right time, maybe doing a double on top of a double XP playlist or something like that. It would really help out. Keep in mind that these stats were really just kind of more like the longest version of what it would take. So yeah, like I said, like, it doesn't take into consideration some boosts, or because that's kind of hard to balance out or try to predict really. Also, XP gained per match is also very much based on your performance and how many medals you get and different achievements you get within the game or commendations that might happen. You get a little boost on top of that. But you definitely want to see, if you ever get a chance to get legendary XP boost packs, definitely do it. 100%. Do it. It's very necessary. If it comes up, I'm definitely will be picking it up as well. So hopefully this video, guys, will give you some realistic expectations when it comes to gaining max rank in Halo 5. So if you found this video informational or you enjoyed it, please make sure to tap that like button, as it greatly helps out the channel a lot. Leave a comment down below what your current progress is in Halo 5 when it comes to your ranks. Hopefully this will give you some rough estimates of what to expect. And if you're new to the channel, stay up to date with anything Halo related, please make sure to tap subscribe with the bell, and I'll catch you all in the next video.